Ganesha visits Gautam's hermitage. Ganesha went to Gautam's hermitage and started living there. He became friendly with everyone there. One day, he told Jaya, Parvati's companion, to assume the form of a cow and eat up all the grain in Gautam's fields. Ganesha said, "When the sages will find you eating the grain, they will try to get you out of the hermitage. The moment they hit you, please pretend to be dead." Gautam tried to shoo away the cow who was eating the grain off his field. No sooner had he struck the cow with a blade of grass than the cow fell to the ground. Ganesha and all other sages rushed to the spot to see what had happened. They saw that Gautam had caused a cow to die. Everybody left the hermitage as they thought that Gautam had committed a sin. Gautam tried to dissuade the sages from leaving. "I will do anything to liberate myself from this curse. Please tell me what I should do," he lamented. Ganesha's advice to Gautam. On hearing sage Gautam's plea, Ganesha proposed a solution. "Can you bring down river Ganga to earth from Shiva's hair? Then you could be freed from the sin when the holy water touches the dead body of the cow," Ganesha told Gautam. As Ganesha had befriended all the sages, they too agreed to what Ganesha said. Gautam was advised to do what Ganesha had suggested. Sage Gautam then went to Mount Kailash and started worshipping Shiva. Appeased by Gautam's devotion, Shiva asked him to state his wish. "O Lord, the earth has been under a bad famine for a long time. It is in need of water of river Ganga. Kindly let the part of the Ganga that is tangled in your hair descend to earth," said Gautam. Shiva readily agreed. The rest of river Ganga descended to earth and liberated the sage of his sin. This part of the Ganga that was brought to earth by sage Gautam was called Gautami Ganga. Sage Gautam and Ahalya. Yet one more tale tells us how sage Gautam brought down river Ganga to earth in the form of river Godavari. Gautam and his wife Ahalya resided on a mountain called Brahma Parvat. Deep penance was performed by the sage and his wife for 10,000 years. During their long worship, there was a drought in the forest for 100 years. Living beings started to die due to the shortage of water. Gautam worshipped Lord Varun, the god of water. Varun appeared and granted Gautam a wish. Gautam asked for rain. Varun could not grant that boon as it was not in his powers. He told Gautam to wish for something else. Gautam then asked for a pond that would be full of water always. Varun instantly granted this wish as it was well within his power. Everybody living in or near the hermitage started using the water of that pond. Every day, sage Gautam's disciples also went to fetch water from the pond. Ganesha arrives at the hermitage. One day, Gautam's disciples were stopped from taking water from the pond by the wives of the other sages. These wives troubled Ahalya too. They put false allegations on her. They lied to their husbands that it was Ahalya who did not let them take water from the pond. The sages hatched a plot to teach Gautam and Ahalya a lesson. They prayed to Lord Ganesha. When Ganesha appeared, the sages told him, "Please fulfill our wish that sage Gautam and Ahalya should be taught a lesson and banished from the hermitage." Ganesha was aware that the sages were asking for an unfair boon. He decided to teach the sages and their wives a lesson. But he wanted to do so wisely. Gautam owned paddy and grain fields. Ganesha turned himself into a thin and hungry cow. He started eating the crops in the fields.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.